everyone, it's Yumiko. Welcome back to my channel. For today's video, I wanted to do a story time video for you guys. I wanted to tell you guys about the opportunity I had a few years back, actually. The opportunity I had to see one of the biggest J-pop, J-rock sensations out there, T.M.Revolution. Getting to see T.M.Revolution was truly a dream come true. T.M.Revolution is one of those artists that I always had on one of my hit lists. One of the things I wanted to do at least once in a lifetime. I have a list of J-rock bands I want to see at least once before I die. And that includes bands such as The Gazette, LS9, Lynch, one of the more recent bands, Zaza, of course. You guys know I absolutely love Zaza. And also, TMR. Listening to this, I'm sure some of you are like, hit list once in a lifetime, Yumiko? Aren't you being a little dramatic? No, I'm not, guys. And I'll tell you the story of why. Why getting to see T.M.Revolution back in 2017 for Otakon's Anisong Matsuri was such a dream come true for me. Feel free to go grab a drink and a snack, maybe even a warm blanket, and let's get started. So I guess I could get started with this video by telling you guys a little bit about T.M.Revolution. So T.M.Revolution, or Takanori Nishikawa, or Nishikawa-san as I called him when I met him, is a bit of a J-pop legend. I'm not making this up, guys. He's a bit of a renaissance man in Japan, incredibly popular. He is a J-pop, J-rock singer, as well as an actor. And yeah, he's a bit of a G, and he's had a career of over 20 years. He has had many of his singles and many hits on the Oricon charts in Japan. Those of you guys who don't know, the Oricon charts in Japan is like our billboards here in the States. I believe billboards are used in Britain as well, aren't they? Kind of off topic, but he's had so many hits, starting from his debut album Makes Revolution. I mean, that song hit number 20 on the Oricon chart, I believe. Many of his anime songs are also Oricon chart hits. Heart of Sword, for example, I know a lot of you out there might know that song from the Rurouni Kenshin anime. That anime hit the Oricon chart at number 6 when it first came out in 1996. I feel like that song, honestly, might be a big song for a lot of us out there, because Rurouni Kenshin really was one of those anime that made it big, one of the very first anime, really, that made it big here in the United States. And Ignited was actually one of the openings for Gundam Seed Destiny, and that song hit number 1 on the charts in 2004. Oh, I almost forgot, you guys might have also seen him in his band activities with his work with Abingdon Boys School. Abingdon Boys School, with them, I think Takanori, he did a few hits actually. You guys might remember Innocent Sorrow, which was one of the openings for D Gray Man, as well as Howling from Darker in the Black. We Are was a song Takanori Nishikawa did for the Sengoku Bazara series. I loved his work with Abingdon Boys School. I feel like they were definitely more my kind of music, if you will, because they were definitely more on the rock side. Just such a talented guy, TMR. By the way, the song he did for Innocent Sorrow, that was actually certified gold. What a powerhouse of a performer Nishikawa-san is. And honestly, guys, that was one of the reasons I really dreamt of one day seeing him perform live. He just has an energy and a sort of passion that I really wanted to be a part of and experience. I wonder, does like Nishikawa-san ever sleep? Like, he has his solo stuff, his acting career, and then he's doing all these collabs with like big names in Japan. For example, Nana Mizuki, the wonderful voice actress, as well as Lunashi and the loves of my life, Kuro Yume. I honestly had no idea when that dream would come true, because even though I lived in an area where a lot of Japanese bands used to come before the panda, you know, nowadays no one comes. Hopefully, someday we'll be together and our Japanese musicians could come here and perform for us. Growing up, I really wasn't allowed to go to a lot of anime conventions and the such because my parents were afraid I'd get abducted or something. It was really frustrating for me as a teenager because here in the DC area, we have had so many bands come here and perform. So many Japanese performers. TMR, for example, he has been coming here to this area pretty regularly, especially to Otakon to perform. He's been performing there for many years now. And it's always been frustrating for me because my friends growing up, my high school friends, they were always allowed to go to anime conventions and, you know, do cosplay and meet Japanese performers. But I always had to stay at home, and it was just so hard for me as someone who really loves Japanese music and Japanese culture. I remember one event was especially hard on me, and that was in 2013 when Otakon had their 20th anniversary. It was a big event at that time, and Otakon was having just so many amazing guests, so many prolific people from the anime industry and the Japanese music industry. There was the wonderful composer Yoko Kanno, who has made so many great music tracks for our anime series out there. There was Homemade Kazuku, another big act in the J-pop scene, who have made amazing songs for big anime such as Bleach and Naruto. There was one of my favorite voice actors out there, Tomokazu Sugita. For those of you who don't know who Mr. Sugita is, he has done so many roles for anime out there. The biggest would probably have to be Gin-chan from Gintama. Gin-chan! I actually love Seiyu, if you guys can't tell. Let me know if you guys want me to talk about my favorite voice actors. Japanese voice actors, by the way, not American voice actors. And I don't just say this because I'm a nerd for Japanese culture and the Japanese language as a whole. I actually think Japanese voice actors are a talent of their own. Like, the culture around Seiyu in Japan is really something else, and I would love to share that with you guys. So do let me know if you would be interested in me talking about that. I definitely plan to do that if there is enough interest out there. And of course, TMR himself was performing for Otakon's 20th anniversary, and I was just so mad I didn't get to go. I remember that was the year I first started college, and yeah, I wasn't able to go because my parents didn't trust me to go by myself, and I didn't have money on my own at the time. So it really was up to them whether or not I could go. And I was just so heartbroken because my dreams were dashed, and I had no idea that this dream would come true. This dream to go see one of the best performers in Japan. I actually remember one of my kohai, when I was in college at that time, she told me about how she got to see TMR live. And like some of my friends from art school at the time also got to see him. And I was so jealous, you guys, like so much FOMO. So much of whether or not my dreams would come true depended on my parents at that time. But you know, this whole experience really taught me that nothing is forever. And in 2017, I all of a sudden found out that Takanori would be performing at Otakon once again, and this time it was different. This time I would be able to go because I had money of my own and I was no longer under the age of 18. So I knew that that summer, August 2017, I just had to go see T.M.Revolution. I didn't know if I would get a chance ever again, so I had no money at that time, and my parents didn't want me to go. I was still living with them at the time, but you know, I fought to go see him. I just knew I had to go see him, or else I would regret it. I was so excited that day when I checked into the hotel to go see T.M.Revolution. I raved about it all weekend with my friends. I remember I texted my anime fan group in our group chat and I was like, wish me luck in kidnapping Nishikawa-san, which is a joke, by the way. I don't want to go to jail. I must say, overall, Otakon, I didn't really care for. I actually thought the staff was kind of rude. And yeah, like, unless there's like a big band going there in the future, I'm not gonna go back. But you know, none of that mattered at that time when I was there, because I got to see TMR and I was so happy. TMR was actually at Otakon for the Anisong Matsuri festival thing. I'm so good with names, guys. I'm such a good YouTuber. He was at Otakon this year along with a bunch of other big acts, for including Flow, which who doesn't know Flow? They're J-Rock, J-Pop giant. And along with Flow and TMR, there was also Yosei Teguku, as well as GEM Project. They're pretty big acts, but really, I was mostly there for Takanori, and I gotta say, he really did deliver. That's not to say the other bands weren't great. GEM Project were powerhouses, and Yosei Teguku was pretty nice as well. I didn't care for Yui-sama's vocals, but the instrumentals were so good. That guitarist of theirs was so talented. And guys, I'm so sorry, but like, I actually lost all the footage, pretty much all the footage I recorded for Otakon weekend. Please, if you learn anything from this video, like, back up your work, guys. It's happened to me so many times that I've taken great footage and I just lost all of it. Like, please back up your work, guys. Like, take this one advice from me. I just have this photo here and a few of other photos of myself from Otakon. Like, I cannot stress the importance of backing up your work. But anyways, back to Takanori. He was so amazing in his performance. He performed a lot of his hit, Thunder, Ignited, and Invoke, and Heart of Swords. Heart of Swords was his last song that he performed, and he was so good. It was really emotional to think about. Like, I really did get emotional. I didn't cry, because I don't cry very easily, unless I get triggered, of course. I really did get emotional during his performance. I couldn't believe that I was there in that moment, getting to have my dream come true. Like, it might seem silly to others, but it was a big deal to me, because I'm not the type of person who is positive about that sort of stuff. I don't expect to achieve my goals. And I hope through hearing me in this video, you realize out there, guys, that dreams do come true. Even for a pessimist like me, my dream of getting to see T.M.Revolution came true. Please, if you're out there struggling to believe in yourself, please keep trying and don't give up, because dreams really do come true. After the performance, we had a wonderful Q&A session where I got to ask him questions in Japanese. One of the Otakon staff, by the way, was so rude to me during the Q&A. Like, I asked the question in Japanese, and before I could even translate, he was like, "What does that mean?" But anyways, I don't let that trap. I didn't let him ruin my mood, because like, it was so nice to get to talk to him during the Q&A, and like, we cheered him on so much. The whole crowd went TMR, TMR, and Takanori deserved all the praise because he's such a hardworking performer. And I even got to say hello to him, and we smiled at each other during the autograph session they had in like the dealer's room. I didn't line up to get his autograph because there was such a long line. Oh my god. I stood by with my friend Randall, and we watched him like work so hard to sign so many things during that autograph session. But overall, just a wonderful memory, and I can't wait to see him perform again in like a legit venue. Like, the Otakon venue is okay, but Takanori has done much better. Like, I'd love to go see him at Budokan or like one of the big venues they have in Japan, like Yokohama Arena or somewhere like that. Staying positive, one day I'll get to see my favorite bands again. Oh my god, guys, before we go, I forgot to say, I actually got VIP tickets to Otakon to go see TMR, which, by the way, were worth every penny. If you guys plan to go to conventions anytime soon, get those VIP tickets. They're worth every penny. Not just because, like, you get free cool free stuff, but also because you don't have to wait on those long ass lines. You know those big lines at anime conventions where you have to stand in the sun for like an hour? VIP tickets. They're the best. I forgot to show you the stuff I got back in 2017 because I got VIP tickets. So here I have two of the autograph things. This is of Jam Project and of course my boy. Oh, this is one of my treasures, guys. And part of the VIP tickets, we also got to shake hands with the members. And while we were shaking hands, I actually said to Nishikawa-san, I was like, Nishikawa-san, sugoi! And he said, thank you. So that was a wonderful memory. By the way, guys, I also forgot to show you this. I am having a moment while trying to film this video. But Otakon that year, I also got to purchase this poster, a little off topic here, by one of my favorite artists out there, Yumei. You might already know Yumei if you're an internet kid like me. She got her start on DeviantArt. I got to buy this poster from her because she was attending Otakon that year. And we even got to chat and take a photo together, which I lost. Oh my god. Not gonna rant about saving data, don't worry. Once is enough. I got to buy this poster from her and she signed the back for me. Where's her signature? Somewhere here. Come on, focus. Focus. But yeah, just an overall wonderful memory. I think that's it for this video, you guys. Sorry if I rambled a little bit. I am still getting used to filming again. And I didn't really write a proper script for this video. Just wrote down my little note. But I hope you like this sort of video. For me, please give me a thumbs up. Let me know, what bands have you seen so far? What performances out there have really made an impact on you? But yeah, that's it for me, Yumiko. Please give me a like if you enjoyed this. And subscribe to my channel for more content. And I will talk to you all later then, J-Rock babies. Bye!